10 seconds remaining.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to say welcome back one last time for today as we head into our 8th game here on Line 3, the International 2016 European Regional Qualifiers. My name is Dragon Job, I'm joined by Gorgon, and what a game to end on at Finnem. With a good start here, I've been struggling a little bit since, but Team Secret, obviously, the open qualifier team, with some promise, to say the least.
Team Secret getting rid of the Ricky here, that makes a lot of sense. They love to run junglers, even though normally when you would see the Darkseer banned out from your opponents, that implies maybe they don't want to run the Ricky. You get rid of it anyway, if you're Team Secret. They are very likely to pick up like an Enchantress here, or maybe an Enigma. They just love junglers. They're very greedy.
Yeah. One of the few teams that actually still do run these kind of heroes, right? I mean,
Normally,
you very rarely see Enigma. You very rarely see Enchantress. And
you very rarely
when you do,
see junglers
sometimes you
at
see
all.
Them. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And even when you see Enchantress, it's more often than not, like in the Americas, as it's kind of an offlaner instead of the jungler straight up.
And has been for a long time now. But
yeah.
Team Secret have a different approach to the game. And that approach is get everybody to the point where they can be a playmaker. Very few teams can actually execute this, but Team Secret are patient and they're really good at shifting responsibility around the map, right?
Yep.
What really collapsed for them at Frankfurt is that, or excuse me, at Manila, they had too many cooks in the kitchen, so to speak. Most of the games you saw Arteezy and Eternal Envy both going out to solo farm and getting caught out on opposite sides of the map because they drafted so greedy and they hadn't quite yet synced up how they managed to do that and how much contribution Universe as the offlaner needed to make that a safe strategy. But with Bulba here so far, they seem to have hit a stride. At least they seem to be on the upward swing of being able to run these greedier drafts successfully again.
Already with a decent opener here for Team Secret. Started with the Timbersaw, which is a hero that has been banned out at the latest in the second phase quite a bit recently here in these games, and they also get their hands on the Elder Titan. Secret kind of have to pick your poison, so they banned out the Pilot Die Shadow Demon, which he has been using to great effect, and also Darkseer, which is one of go-to heroes. But speaking of go-to, Disruptor as well, even in Manila, I believe he was the most picked hero with 40 games out of the 99. So that's making a return for Ad Finnem.
Yeah, and so for Ad Finnem, if we're just taking a look at the way that the bracket has been dropping down, they're running pretty even, right? And they did beat we said this earlier, they beat Escape Gaming, which is, that's a good team. No Diggity have been on the upward swing. They're usually one of the top three teams in Europe's qualifiers for other LAN events. Granted, those qualifiers don't usually include Secret, but, and even, maybe not even Alliance. Even so, the fact that Ad Finnem have not only done pretty well in the qualifier season up until now, moving through trying to get into the Star Ladder and trying to get into Nanyang and trying to get into the Summit. They've done pretty well most of those qualifiers, and they continue to do pretty well today. But Secret are 3 wins, 1 loss. They've only lost to Virtus Pro, who have come out pretty much on top, I would say, of the round robin so far.
Yeah, they're actually tied with Secret right now with the standings on Joint Dota, to be believed, without the date. 3-1, same for Fantastic Five. So, might not be too up to date, though, so keep that in mind. But yeah, it's, they're up there. Virtus Pro, really impressed by their performance up in Secret earlier. But yeah, that's neither here nor there. A Secret going for the second phase ban. Also take out that Terror Blade that we've seen crop up every now and again.
Yeah, so the Terror Blade we've been seeing a lot today, specifically, but especially if Ad Finnem are going to use the Beastmaster and Disruptor, there is no innate answer to the Terror Blade in those two heroes. There's not enough rotation potential in the early game to shut them down. There's not enough AoE potential to shut them down in the late game. So you would have to draft 2 or 3 heroes later on, specifically to deal with the Terror Blade if you had any chance. They may also want to get rid of the Broodmother, to be honest, because although we don't see it that often, it's something that we know Secret can run. And it's something that they, once again, don't necessarily have answers to. They kind of have the wild axes, but other than that.
It's second phase. This is where we get into the meat of the draft, generally speaking.
Yep. Yep, the meat and potatoes coming out here in the second phase. A Faceless Void would go a long way here for Team Secret if they do want to run that Timbersaw mid. But if it's an offlane Timbersaw, which we still see once in a while, though I think mid is more common now.
I don't think it's a Bulba hero, though.
So that's true. Yeah. Well, it could be. Here's the thing with Bulba. We never really got an opportunity. Like, he barely played any games with EG, right, on ticket.
Yeah,
so
okay.
It's been a while since we've seen Bulba's play a lot while Timbersaw was popular. So maybe he plays it. I've just not seen it. You know, maybe it's a back pocket pick. The Witch Doctor, once again, does imply that a Faceless Void would be there. 10 seconds
remaining. Yeah, also one of these classic Paladai heroes.
Yeah.
You're talking about Team Secret looking to turn everyone into a playmaker, and it goes a long way if you can get your people, if you can get heroes that your players are really, really comfortable with. So that it just comes naturally to you, like the advanced things, just finding the right cast, the best possible cast in every situation is also something that can make a difference as well. That you just see, right? You kind of automatically do that without even really thinking about it too much if you're just so comfortable with a hero.
Right. Yeah, I mean, this is one of their most played heroes. And of course, Slark is one of the most played heroes for Ad Finem as well.
Dara is a monster on this hero, so a little bit surprised that Team Secret didn't actually ban it out, but well, maybe they're not fearing it. Maybe they have a solution.
So, I don't know what the win rate between Slark and Timbersaw is, but theoretically at least, the stat drain doesn't really affect Timbersaw so much because he basically uses Chakram and Whirling Death for his damage. So it doesn't matter that much that he's losing physical damage. Yeah, nobody really likes to have their stats sapped, but like Timbersaw probably handles it better than most. And moreover, reactive armor presumably
is
pretty good against Slark.
Slark is a Shadowblade builder. Slark is a Silver Edge builder.
Oh, eventually when the Silver Edge comes out. But in theory, I think with the lineup that Secret have here, they want to be ahead by then. Elder Titan is a hero that wants to scale very quickly with levels and doesn't care very much about gold. Witch Doctor is sort of the same way, right? He wants to scale very quickly with levels. And Timbersaw, up until like level 10 or 11, wants to scale with levels and then needs to get the Bloodstone before he hits his next power spike. So all three of these heroes need to get off to a good start. Slaughter is going to be the next pick.
I suggest there's some synergy with Witch Doctor. But outside that, it's just to provide more control and the brawling potential.
Yeah, also, potentially, there is some synergy alongside the natural order of the Elder Titan. You're amplifying damage with the amplified damage from the Slardar, and then natural order reduces base armor by up to 100%, which means that you're now amplifying instead of just reducing resistance. Truly amplifying damage with the amplified damage. Just to say amplified like 7 or 8 more times. Get it out.
Amplify, amplify, amplify. Team Ad Finem, 1 more minute to go on the reserve time. Looking for support, still looking for mid lane. The normal ones come to mind, like Invoker, Pain of Pain perhaps, something with a bit of burst damage, maybe even deal with the Timbersaw, kind of try and deal with the Slaughter as well when he's in sprints, get that extra bit of damage out.
I think a Death Prophet and a Dazzle here would be pretty decent for them. It gives them that negative armor to deal with the Timbersaw. It gives them the push to maximize out that Beastmaster's potential in the mid game and open up space for the Slark. The Grave obviously works really well with the Slark because he's able to dive in. He can get graved, then he shadow dances, and he comes out with full health again. So there's a fair amount of synergy there. They're going to go with the Lion. That gives them some interrupt for the Witch Doctor. Up until this point, they didn't really have good interrupt, barring the Disruptor Glimpse, which you ideally want to save to kill a hero. I mean, Lion's obviously a very strong pick in general. There's a reason that he's been one of the most picked heroes for...
Pretty much. He hasn't really been touched. He always is always able to provide you with that lockdown, generally, unless the game is going really badly for you, and you have some space to give him farm priority. It's going to get like 20-25 minute blink dagger for the instant hex initiation. Just an all-around solid support hero.
And you also mentioned something, there's a value to picking comfortable heroes, and because Lion hasn't really been touched, and he did start to gain popularity at the end of 6, everybody has a good Lion. Yeah. It's been so long, and he hasn't been nerfed, and he's not a first pick, first ban in most cases. So he is like the ultimate comfort hero.
So
the Death Prophet is going to be the ban out of TCG. I think that's a good pick, or a good ban, obviously. Pick. 5 seconds. I'm interested to see what Ad Finem pull out here in the mid lane. If it is a mid Timbersaw, then they pretty much are going to need somebody to have nukiness in the lane in order to contest. So maybe a Puck might come out to stack up with the Disruptor.
Oh, I wouldn't hate that. A bit of extra burst down. The control, the silence is also going to be super useful against Timber.
Mm-hmm.
Just top of the Static Storm. More than enough to deal with it.
Yeah.
And Puck is something that the Tuck likes to run. He's just some stats here when it comes to wins and losses. I mean, and back to the comfort zone, the point that we made earlier. Puck would be 5-4 for Tuck here before today. Slark, Madara, 7-1 before today. Disruptor, 3-1 for Spartan.
It
and
is the Invoker
even
that you
4-1
call.
For maybe next time, but it's going to be the Invoker. Also,
I don't
Puck
hate the Invoker.
Sure.
I think that's pretty good here. Yeah. They don't have a lot of answers to the Timbersaw, which may end up becoming an issue, but they've got pretty decent answers to the Witch Doctor and Elder Titan. The Faceless Void ban there, though. Yeah. Just because the offlane was picked does not necessarily mean that you can't run Void as a carry, and Elder Titan, Witch Doctor, and Timbersaw all do massive damage from the outside of a Chronosphere.
Thing is also, I believe this might have even been at Finem. Yeah, it was at Finem earlier. One of the games that I had with mod packs. Also ran the Invoker, also last pick, up against Timbersaw, and there was a Quaz Wex, and then obviously you have that the Tornado EMP available. And Timbersaw without mana is kind of a tanky version of a melee creep. And that's about
it. Yeah. He hits pretty hard, he just doesn't hit very fast.
Yeah.
But he doesn't really get anything done, you're right, without mana. If it is a Quaz Wex Invoker, if that's something Ad Finem are running, I don't think I've seen any pro player run a Quaz Wex in a month and a half. To be honest.
Well, actually, earlier today, so you can trust me on that one. Might be.
Yeah.
Yeah, the important thing is that it kind of leaves you thin on damage in the early game.
It also kind of leaves you thin on push potential. Then it's just the Beastmaster.
Well.
Lifestealer coming out, very standard kind of reactionary pick there. That's, once again, one of those comfort picks. Stardust going to have a Blink Dagger. You can get into the Timbersaw as well for initiation. He chews through the Beastmaster pretty well. Not really an answer to the Slark, but other than that, it's a decent pick.
He's not going to die as quickly to a Slark, right?
It's really good against the Disruptor, though, which is something that they needed, because Disruptor is generally pretty good against both Slaughter and Timbersaw.
Alright, everyone's picking their heroes. We're slowly but surely getting into our last game of the day here in the EU qualifiers. As was mentioned earlier, Ad Finem taking on Team Secret. And
I can't believe we're already to the last game of the day. Everybody's been joining us and stopping in and watching the EU qualifiers. Thanks. You know, it's nice to be here. It's nice that Valve invited us, Drag and Drop. I feel good about it.
Especially in a qualifier that is this stacked. Right? I mean, EU has always been known for being that. But just getting the chance to cast is just such a treat, such a pleasure to be here.
Yeah, not that I would, you know, every region has been fun to watch, and I put on games while I was sleeping or whatever, you know, like, just kind of trying to catch some of SEA in China, and I'm going to try to catch some of the Americas a little bit later on, but I don't think there are any regions that don't have good Dota going on in this qualifier, but I would say that Europe probably is likely to have the best Dota.
All right. And there's still more Dota tomorrow, right, for both of us?
Yeah.
Starting with China, and then you're also going to take over for some more EU.
Yeah, you're doing China tomorrow. Have fun with that. China's
I just
another
hope the
good region
don't
to watch
out,
right
now. That's kind of a big issue with Perfect World sometimes. I mean, sometimes servers are fine, sometimes they just throw you out and not let you have a fun time. But that's tomorrow. Right now, we have some predictions to do as everyone's loaded in.
All right. Player with most D wards coming out here. That's a tough call. I'm going to go ahead and guess. I want to guess Pylaidai. It's probably either Pylaidai or Spartan, right? But I think Pylaidai is probably going to be rotating a little bit more.
First Roshan kill Secret, I want to say, just because of Slaughter. You have that amplified damage, you can actually take it at Finem. Don't have Roche heals, especially considering that it's probably... Hey, it's actually Quasi-Exalted Invoker, so...
Yeah.
find that.
I agree. I think that probably Secret. Yeah. If they control the map at all, Roche is likely theirs. Player with fewest deaths.
Last time I had Madara on the Slark, I died 2 times, and it was maybe next time playing the Disruptor, then he only died once, and that was neutral deny. So I don't know if
I'm actually going to go for Arteezy on this one.
Yeah,
I think,
okay.
Yeah, if he doesn't get harassed out of the lane, Timbersaw is just really hard to kill. Granted, he can suicide, and I guess that counts as a death, because it's not a, even though it's not a kill, but...
Should,
yeah. I'm going to give Arteezy some props. I haven't seen him play Timbersaw, but I'm putting some faith in him.
I'm just going to go back for Madara. Just hoping that he won't die as much as that. He didn't even die much. Died 2 times throughout the entire game when that was the thing. But hey, it's going to go trust in a Slark and his innate survivability. Yeah, play with highest net worth by 10 minutes. That's a good one. Also Madara, I want to say, because he's farming extremely well.
I'm torn between Madara and Eternal Envy. But Eternal Envy is also going to have Beastmaster creeps to potentially farm, so either he's getting little extra boosts of gold there, or he's being left alone. I'm going to go for Eternal Envy, but it really could go either way.
Yeah. Well, it's too late for me. I locked in Madara as well. I believe in the Greeks. And... Secret?
I just realized I picked a secret hero for every single one. I said I just realized I picked a secret hero for every single one. I probably should have split it up. That makes me seem like super one-sided.
Oh well. Hashtag biased caster, everyone flame Gorgon please on Twitter. That's the one account.
But I'm gonna get off the stream with just 10,000 biased casters.
Yeah,
Cyborg right. Matt's gonna flame me in the Discord chat. Alright, so as when we're out here, Puppy already starting with the brown boots and getting ready to rotate around. I like this decision for the build, and he's actually gonna scout out maybe next time, who wanted to wrap around behind Bulba, but now is thinking twice about it.
The Titan. I mean, Puppy went for these Spirit first. I've watched a lot of Team Toast throughout the open qualifiers, and Steph Star has been playing Elder Titan pretty much every single game. He went for the Stomp first, and I believe this bug is still there. We get the double damage off with the physical and the magical, because you don't have the Spirit just yet. And that's also pretty damn good at just zoning out a single offlaners, and maybe even wrapping around towards the middle lane. The enemy hero is just a little bit too far forward, and you can get the complete wraparound.
Yeah, I really like that they're keeping the Elder Titan up here as well, because it's very unlikely that Eternal Envy has a significant amount of trouble dealing with Skylark down here, especially with Pylai Dai kind of hanging in the general area. They're going to move on Skylark, actually.
It's not slow
down
the cast.
If they get a lucky bounce, they don't.
Still I still get it here with Maledict.
Nah, Maledict level 1 is not enough.
I'll wait for it to take out, then the salve will be there.
Yeah. That was very... If that were a lucky bounce, though, that would have been your first blood.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
So it's just a little unfortunate on the cast, but still zoning him out, like I said, probably not going to have too much trouble down this bottom lane. Meanwhile, that frees up the Elder Titan to hang out up here in the top lane a lot and shut down Skylark a little bit. Or excuse me, shut down Madara. Thus protecting my Eternal Envy flame.
Well, we'll see. He'll end up being victorious here by 10 minutes. Bulba actually gets a crush off
spot. Top,
look at
this,
the stomp is there. Waiting for a little bit of extra creep damage to get the last right click in, but Madara just has to blink out. Or jump out, I should say.
Yeah, Bulba getting their first blood last hit on that as well. That's going to help him get up to that blink dagger much more quickly. He's pretty survivable up here. He might be vulnerable for a counter kill if Puppy leaves him alone, but barring that, it doesn't seem very likely.
Puppy's Man, running Puppy's out of mana, but he work. Has plenty of money to go into the Soul Ring.
Yeah.
What's going on here? Look at this. Eternal Envy, Pylai Dai, and just skipping Greed Waves. I don't give a damn.
Arteezy's freaking me out with this oil river thing. Okay, so I've had Carpal Tunnel for the last month or so. I haven't played basically any Dota for the last two patches. Since 6.8.6, that's my Carpal Tunnel. I've just been casting and watching and analyzing. Yeah. I can do that without my wrists. But that means that I've not played any games with this river thing going on. So every time it happens in a pro game, it freaks me out.
Arteezy is actually the only one that I've seen do that. I mean, I forget about it in my games.
Right.
It's like very rare that I actually remember, you have to actually buy the thing in the shop, but then you have to use it. Arteezy is the second time I've seen it from him.
Right. Yeah, that's the thing, too. It happens in pro games so rarely that I'm not used to it, but Arteezy does do it a lot. So, you know, just freaking me out. Taking a look at the way that this should transition toward the mid game, we're about 3 minutes in, so laning phase has some time yet. Slark is being zoned out a bit, and that is forcing his supports to hang out here as well, giving Arteezy actually pretty free reign here in the mid lane. They need to be able to split one of these supports away to come over here and harass Arteezy out to make sure Thug is having a good lane. But as long as the Elder Tyne and Slardar are up here, I don't really know that AF can respond in any significant way. So this aggression, basically Puppy is the linchpin for this entire success of all three lanes.
Doing a good job so far, yeah. There's level 3 now, so 2 points up in the stomp, making that all that more efficient. But Bulldog kind of come from the wrong side. Nara will get that off into the pounds. I still stomp though to stop anything else from happening. They're gonna wake up one. It's gonna be maybe next time, and easy kill for them as they turn it around. Looking for more here, Madara, level 6 yet, can't really heal up, and Spartan super, super slow. They get the crush, another kill.
Yeah, this lane is going very well, obviously, for TC.
Oh, Madara,
he's thinking about moving in. The crush is there.
Huge mistake with my predictions. I'm just seeing them fall apart right now already, only 4 minutes in.
Yeah, and meanwhile, complete free farm here for turn 1 to be down in the bottom. Timbersaw also getting very good farm. Not free farm because Thug is here, but he's doing very well for himself. Timbersaw is a hero that, to do poorly in the lane, either needs to be playing up against a lot of nuke or needs to be playing up into heavy rotations. And the Invoker doesn't have the nuke, and AF haven't felt able to rotate away. Honestly, they might even be better off sacking some of Madara's farm now, not to cancel out your predictions, but just forcing Madara to sit back so that they can rotate the supports out to mid, at least make sure one of their lanes is going to go well.
Not so far. Had Finem only have issues. I guess Skylark's farming, right? He went for the rather early Iron Talon so he can do the struggle thing as a Beastmaster. Yeah. So he's gonna have a fairly reasonably timed level 6, and maybe then's the point where he can get some momentum coming back towards the Venom.
Yeah, I'm not sure that it's a case where you're happy about that, because it also means that Eternal Enemy is going to be farm, and it means that another support is free to rotate for Secret. So the Witch Doctor is probably going to go mid or top here and try to make additional kill opportunities. Once again, Puppy just hanging out up here and being so aggressive and such a pain. The entire strategy from Secret comes down to him. All three lanes, basically, he's winning. Just on the back of his positioning and his ally's technical skill.
Go for Bulba now, the crush comes out, Madara gets the purge off, but the Sunstrike wasn't even enough to bring him down. Paladai with rotation in, only used the cask and the Maledict on maybe next time. Bulba quick enough to get in for another crush.
What a rotation.
And it just...
Paladai might actually get Spartan here, he's getting pretty close. No
God,
mana
no.
for the paralyzing cast.
This Arteezy finds Skylark in the jungle.
Jeez, and he's got a haste rune, he's gonna come up behind.
Yeah.
He could kill Spartan with just a Chakram, and he's going to find him right now. He sees him, and that's death.
That's getting caught with kinetic fields. Stomp is there, though. Lion stun. He's just exposing himself to another kill. Arteezy has plenty of mana for another couple of spells. Doesn't even
wow.
I have no words for this. Madara's going to die, too.
Oh, he gets himself caught in the trees. The stomp is there. The follow-up stun. 9-0. Secret R. Definitely in control of this game.
Well, TZ with the highest net worth right now. Something else maybe I'm wrong. Play with the least devs, well, Madara's not gonna get that.
Yeah, yeah, there's no way that anybody's gonna catch up to RTZ in the next 3 minutes. Here's the deal, RTZ's been a part of kills now, whereas the Lifestealer has been free farming, but he's not getting those little bits of burst gold in addition.
Yep. Well, Paladai has sentry, so maybe starts dewarding. It's my last hope right now for this game. Because that Finem, they're not off to a good great start at all, and don't think they have the best comeback heroes either.
Getting a deward, saving one of your predictions.
Oh! You just had to jinx it, didn't you?
Spartan, what a player! He did that just to screw with you. It's nothing to do with this game.
Yeah.
He just wants you to get a big zero. They are going to be moving
time,
on the Thug
last
here.
Last time, just not dying. Okay, that is.
Nice stomp.
Stomp
follow
comes
up
out
stomp from Bulba. And Arteezy should be enough to finish this off. Now up onto the high ground, onto maybe next time he can dive the tower without any trouble here whatsoever. He does get stunned. Arteezy diving in, getting that reactive armor stacked up from the tower, throws out the chakram, is going to get it. The stomp goes out and does not hit Spartan. There's going to be the crush though. Oh god, Madara, you gotta run, friend. He's trying to move on to Bulba, but now the damage coming out of Madara, he's caught between three and being corralled under his tower. Has to hope that nobody dives him. Skylark, jeez.
Doesn't even fear him. No mana, no health points, but it doesn't fear Madara or anyone at all right now.
Right. He is actually getting pretty close to his
maybe next time.
Too.
Oh, they get the hex up onto Bulba. Thug is there as well. Doesn't throw out spells just yet. The cast comes through. Now they have to run away. The stomp catches him. Crush does not. Let's play perhaps we're still. Yeah, that's actually means that Thug is able to get himself out. Mind a victory.
This is the most dominating performance I've seen outside of open qualifiers in a long time.
Yeah.
That's the secret really rolling this game very well. They should be able to collapse down on Roche after the tower too.
Well hey, if Secret get another 12 kills without dying, it's gonna be 2-4-0. Or 0-2-4. 420 again. Hey. See?
Numbers are fun, and I think you might have just had a stroke. Those might not be related concepts.
You just don't know about the meme, do you?
The 0-2-4 stomp. I don't know about Yeah.
And I went. What was that? It was actually a while ago.
You're
Whatever.
I think you're thinking too hard about it. The stomp is gonna come out here, Spartan. I mean, if you can't work with this, think about how AF must feel. Follow up by Puppy, and boom, General Envy comes up, finishes off the kill. Couple more of those bad boys, and maybe he gets himself out front. He's got 12 seconds to do it. Save my prediction, but Arteezy's way, way too far. Timbersaw is a hero that does really well with levels, but if you give him levels and farm, there are a few heroes that just become pub stomp style that to a greater degree, right? With the mana that he'll have from the Bloodstone that he almost has finished. I don't really know what AF do to stop him. The Disruptor is the only decent counter they have to him.
Doesn't even have level 6. It doesn't even have level 5.
Yeah. Taking a look at the levels, in fact. Level 3 on the Lion, level 4 on the Disruptor. Everybody from Secret is 6 or above. Arteezy is almost level 10.
Going well. I guess Thark will have his Midas soon, so that's something.
Oh man, and Slark is going for a late Midas. Is he going for a Midas?
I think I kind of have to at this point, don't you?
No, I think probably going into some sort of a combat item or initiation item so that he can try to pick off Pylai Dai. That's probably better, in my mind. Right? You pick off Pylai Dai or you pick off Puppy, and you get some of that rubber band mechanic gold going on from those kills. That the Midas, by the time that pays off, you already lost the game at this rate.
Yep.
Like, literally, it's going to take 20 minutes before that pays off in gold. It'll take 7 or 8 minutes before it's worth it for the experience. And that's if you can use it on jungle creeps every single time it's off cooldown. Right now, it doesn't even look like he'll have control of his own jungle long enough for that to be the case. Skylark gets a kill.
Oh,
I missed
that.
I'm not sure if you grabbed it.
I did not, but that was a roll being used. So.
TT Tours.
Look at Spartan in return, though, by the looks of it. But Cass bouncing back a third time and a bit of a trigger point.
That glimpse, though.
Yeah, super value.
Slark is
going
into the Shadowblade. I think this is much more reasonable build for trying to make a comeback here. Not only are you going to force a little bit of your opponent's net worth advantage to be spent on Vision, which, I mean, that's a small game, but it is a game. And, you know, you're more likely to be able to find support on the back line, blow them up, and then escape. And these supports are pinatas of glory. But it's because Secret is so far ahead that comeback mechanic would really bounce Skylark very hard if he gets 3 or 4 kills in a row.
Can he, though? I mean,
Yeah.
Look at Pylai Dai. He's kind of the easiest target. Depending on whether he goes more points into Restoration, I get a question whether Madara actually has the damage to bring him down before any help can arrive at the very least, and he pays for it. And if you look at Puppy, he's sitting at 7 armor and 1,000 health points right now.
Yeah, Puppy is not the ideal target. He also has to stomp, but, you know, with the pounce damage, with the Dark Pact, and then probably a follow-up Shadow Dance, he might be able to kill Pylai Dai. There's the glimpse onto Puppy.
Spartan, follow up Sunstrike comes in. Arteezy to kind of try and trade, just goes right into the Static Storm. He doesn't give a damn. And now, easy kill on the poor little disruptor.
So, it's. I like how we're having a discussion wondering, hey, if AF's farming carry gets some more farm, can he solo kill Secret's 5-spot support? And while we're having that discussion, AF's 5-spot support tries the 1v3 for a kill.
Well, AF's. Yeah. It's a bit weird. And also, Secret's 5-position support has more net worth than the 4 and the 5 together.
Yeah.
For Ed Venom.
Yeah.
Four of the top 5 are in. And Secret's favor, Lion does again, I don't even care anymore. And Puppy has more gold than Madara. Just think.
That's. Well, to be fair, Puppy has been literally taking it out of his cold dead hands all game. So. I mean, Madara is now sitting with 2 deaths, no assists, because there's only 1 kill on his team. They're going to try to move on to Envy.
He
does
get him here with the roar, but he's out of his way to victory with Stomp coming in, running interference, glimpse back, not going to put Puppy too far away. Going to get the counter kill on the Skylark. Now the Death Ward, more than enough to get rid of another one. And Lion, I think there's just Tilty going back into that.
Teezy
with a double kill.
That was tilted so hard you lost your ball if you were playing pinball. That was ridiculous. The Lion went in and hexed to interrupt the Witch Doctor ultimate after his ally had died. Which means while he was running in, he was the target of the Death Ward. And then once he got there, there was nobody else to focus on. Elder Titan getting another kill as well. Lifestealer getting low, but that's just because of armlet toggles. Yeah, there was no reason to re-engage there for AF. They are out of their minds right now. We put a fair amount of faith in the Secret, but this is ridiculous.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, I did not expect this to be this one-sided. 20 and 1, 15 minutes in, 12k net worth advantage. Predictions are all screwed up, thank you guys.
Well, this is a low percentage game. You can't predict Team Secret come out over AF. With the dominance of a baboon beating up an infant. You know what I mean? It's just...
I got a question now whether I'm even going to get the Roshan kill prediction.
Right?
Because like, Secret don't have to go for
why
Roche.
Bother?
Yeah.
They might get Roche after they get this tower, or maybe they'll probably rotate mid, and then they might fall back in Roche, because why not?
Yeah.
You know, there's no reason not to, but they don't need it. Probably. I can't imagine that they need it to break high ground at this point. I mean, we haven't even talked about the farm, because it's been so... obviously dominant, but there's a full Echo Saber armlet on the Lifestealer, and Envy is not even that far away from his Desolator. Meanwhile, Madara has only recently finished his Shadow Blade.
Top lane. Skylark gets killed. Mass rotations come in from 3 different heroes. Skylark trying to TP out. Will not be able to.
That is a sad lark. And
it's only
Madara...
3 seconds, but those are an eternity.
Oh, Madara can get Pylai Dye here. But he misses the pounce! That was the one opportunity he was going to have, and now he has to. He's going to die. Wow. Okay. Wow. That was literally the only opportunity that he's had to get a kill in probably the entire game. And unfortunately, not only did he miss the pounce, but he pounced directly into the tower. Once again, it really feels like AF are starting to lose their calm.
Maybe next time got himself an Invis Ruin, it's the only reason he's alive. He has Bulba, has a passenger, and looking for someone to pick off. Spartan? No, don't show yourself. For the love of God. Alright, he's making his way out.
Yeah, meanwhile, Arteezy has a Timber Saw Split pushing top because he's so far ahead that he can do whatever he wants.
He has 19 Bloodstone Charges and a Boots of Shovels. So.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Okay, so... I'm going to double down. I was about to say, how does AF come back in this, but we already outlined it. It's basically they have to just kill Pylai Dye enough that they get a bounce back. It's really, that's pretty much the only option.
Maybe they can get it easy. It's all alone. They have to roll. They have to start some follow-up. That's a big one.
I thought he was going to suicide there, but he didn't. Okay, well, there goes my prediction, because it's very unlikely that anybody else from Secret that hasn't died is going to die. That's a big kill, too, for it. I mean, not only are they thinning out the Bloodstone charges, but it's worth 2,200 gold.
Yeah. About that going towards the Beastmaster, and that's gonna go right into
Necrophant.
Yeah. So, There's a recipe on the card. Just didn't get it from it just there.
Yeah. They will go towards the Necro because they need to be able to mana drain the Timber Saw. And they honestly just... If he doesn't finish the Necro, he's not maximizing the amount of damage he can do with that money. And at this point, they need every little bit that they... Well, this is going to be another tower lost. Arteezy screwing up predictions by just kind of standing out in the middle of nowhere earlier, but no big deal. It's really screwed up that somebody dies once and you're almost guaranteed that they are not going to have the fewest deaths in the game.
It's a glimpse back, but it drops a packet. It's Eternal Envy is getting scoffed for the Catastatic Storm, though. Does not have the rage, you will fall here.
I'm really shocked that Envy didn't rage there.
Raw to Bilba are gonna get another one. TB will be cancelled. Well, maybe we've been riding off at Phantom too much,
that
but
was
then again, it's still a
hubris.
Huge lead, but...
I mean, Secret...
Also kill, yeah.
But in the last minute, they've given up almost 5,000 net worth from kills that they didn't need to give up. Like, there's no reason that Lifestealer needed to die.
And now, at Phantom, with that, they're gonna screw up my prediction. What the hell?
Yep.
They're promotion now.
Just to make sure that you get absolutely nothing here. Puppy's trying to save you, man.
Yeah,
Puppy's doing it.
It's such a good start.
Look, they
such
don't
a
even
good
care,
start,
though. RTZ could come over here and try to slow this down with the Shock Run, but he just doesn't even care. He's just going to let it happen. Blame RTZ for your prediction loss. All right, so they're going to move in and grab a couple kills here, though, because RTZ can get over here, kill Skylark. It's a very minimal gain, though. Honestly, Skylark's not worth very much. 281 gold. It's 10% of what AF are getting every time they kill Secret. So on the plus side for AF, if they get a couple more kills like the ones they've been getting, they will be able to bounce back in this game, at least potentially. Because Secret, as opposed to normal, a normal Secret draft goes late, much harder than their opponents. But in this case, the Slark goes into late game ceiling stats very effectively. The Lifestealer is not a good answer to the Slark. Invoker goes late very well in addition in terms of the crowd control and damage that he can output. So if Secret play loosey-goosey and just let their avarice get the best of them, yes, AF could bounce back into this game. It's just exceedingly unlikely. That's all.
Yep. There's still Verge completed, so not opting for any sort of Echo Save in between. That's gonna at least help deal with the Timber Saw reactive armor.
Yeah, I think this is the right call, because we saw earlier RTZ barely got killed in that gank, but he did get killed. He is mortal. And with the reduction of the reactive armor, you could realistically see RTZ getting out in front of himself again and getting caught out.
And another thing that I want to point out is the natural order as well. If you look at Puppy, he's about to max it out now.
It's not a super high priority, but it does help.
Yeah, it does help. Like, if the Timber Saw is... If you can deal with Timber Saw on other means, then it's gonna be a nice priority to get that off just to mitigate the amount of damage that you're taking.
Yeah, and also...
It's not a thing that you talk about much because you don't see it all that visibly, but it can make a huge difference.
Natural Order is an immense spell for the late game, because it's, once again, it's a percentage-based spell. Yeah. So... It scales in the late game very, very well. And it's, once again, one of the reasons why Elder Titan does scale into the late game, but doesn't scale with gold particularly well. He just needs levels because his innate kit is almost everything that he does. Wow, Power Rangers Unite down here in the bottom. They will save this tower. No, they won't. The catapult. Okay, Lifestealer gets to deny at least.
Another tower. Still hanging around. I'm sure that's best idea.
Meanwhile, Pylai Dai is going to go down, and Bulba might go down here as well. No, okay. Skylar can't close the gap, but...
Dara has shown himself he does not have... He does have the ultimate and the Silver Edge for another 5 seconds.
I don't know what maybe next time he's doing here.
Maybe next time, it's a much easier pickup.
He was... I don't know if you caught that, but he was, like, way down here. And as the Beastmaster started retreating away because he knew he didn't have the damage, maybe next time just literally ran directly at the Slardar from the south side. Like, it's like they were playing Red Rover or something.
Well, 28-6 now to kill score.
That might be a cultural reference that I realize non-American.
It went right over my head.
So Red Rover is a game that you play on the playground if you're an American whelp. That all the kids hold hands and they call out a child and one of the children has to try and run fast enough to break the grip by running through the arms of the children on the other side. It's a whole thing. Never mind. It's a stupid game kids play. This is the point. Yep. I'm trying to fill time because unless Secret continue, unless Secret make more mistakes like they made a handful of earlier, there's just not a lot to talk about. They're going to wait for the Aegis to expire, which buys Slark some time to get an Echo Saber, but Secret are going to have more resources available, so they'll probably just get more net worth lead during this time.
Well, I won't fill time. I just lament about my lack of prediction accuracy here in these last couple of games, but enough of that.
You're pretty bad at predicting. It's okay.
Started off very well, though. I'm so sad. Oh god, the Roar. Counter Roar thanks to the Lotus Orb, though. Skylar cannot follow up, and now Arteezy, he's angry. He wants to break down his Beastmaster, and he gets some helpful Bulbul with the Crush. Easy Blast on charges, back up to 16 now.
Very nice Lotus Orb play by Timbersaw there, by Arteezy, moving in, and now he's 12-1-4. Bloodstone charges at 16 with a Lotus Orb and Boots of Travel. What do you do? Like, yeah, if he gets caught out all by himself and you have your entire team there again, maybe you can kill him like you did last time. Even last time, they barely got him, though.
Yeah. And this is a 5-minute push. This is not a single pickoff. You don't have your Roar, you don't have your Beastmaster.
I want to reiterate, because there might be people, I'll come back to this, because where Madara is going to be jumping on Pylite Eye, the easy target, and he will be able to grab him down with the Echo Saber. Meanwhile, up in the base, Bulba's going to go and throw out a stop, but the rest of Secret are trying to scream out. Madara will end up going down, but that is just the Aegis, the Finger of Death going down on Arteezy. Arteezy might be going down here, gets four staffed away, but the damage is there. No, he Timber Chains away with less than 100 health. Madara's trying to chase him, he throws up the Channel Blade himself, moving down around the south side. Meanwhile, the help from Bulba coming around, and just barely able to get away from Arteezy, managing to get the teleport home.
How did
Such
no one die there?
Kill, a big kill lost by AF. That really could have been one of those bounce back moments.
Yeah. He got so close. Reactive armor once again. Major play in that.
Yeah. Well, he did break the reactive armor near the end, but
yeah,
Arteezy just able to get out with the teleport.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? The Echo Saber wasn't on Madara yet. I thought he had purchased it, but he hadn't actually gotten it on his person. I thought he had it during that fight. And that probably would have been the make or break for that fight. That's a real bummer. The timing could not have been closer to being right on that.
Oh, yeah. At the very least, they keep the tower alive, right? Which, with that kind of network of Ancient Secret, that's a win in its own, right? Just holding on, extending the game a little bit longer to keep trying to find some more of these kind of opportunities where you can finish out the kill.
Right. The longer they really play, the more likely it is that Secret makes a mistake. But they also did trade in the Aegis for that fight, and all they got was a Disruptor on their team dying.
I think it was about to expire anyway, so it's not the big idea.
But the point is, they don't have it for a high ground defense now, which means they now have to rely on buyback potential, and they don't have buybacks on a lot of their heroes. In fact, they only have a buyback on the Invoker and the Disrupt. But before that fight started, I just wanted to reiterate that this entire... Never mind, because Spartan is now just going to blow up.
Don't even talk about it.
Teleport in onto
this
the Spirit.
This is so stupid that you can do that. You can also Omni Slash on it if you're posing Juggernaut.
Yeah, it's a unit. It counts. Do you remember when the Elder Titan spirit would continue to move if it started to get recalled and you stomped? It would move and you could stomp while it moved by, like a drive-by. It was so broken.
Oh, yeah.
It was insane. And then you could also have like a Tinker teleporting to it. That was back when 2014, when Tinker was really, really big. That was crazy. They're going to try to move on to Puppy here. They will be able to turn off his orb, Eternal Envy. This is a bad move. Highlight Eyes here as well. Yeah. It is time to retreat, my friend. Oh no, Madara is being seen.
He should be fine, unless they can maybe look for him in the side. I'm in the Silver Edge. I'm not sure what the state of detection is. Not have a
the state of
the
detection is
right
who
now.
Cares if he shows himself and kill him then.
Oh, look, they see him on the side here. They find Skylar, like, his rest TP's out.
Yeah. Everybody has forced the TP away from AF, like hiding their shame as they go back to their base, and without a buyback on the Beastmaster and without an Aegis in their side, I don't really know what they do to defend the side ground.
I don't think Crush
that,
with a package, that's an easy kill, no buyback either. Spartan, 1-2-3. This is the game. I hate to call it already, but yeah.
It's
gonna get better.
It's almost certainly, we're talking like 99.7% win rate at this kind of a lead. It's pretty much been game for a while. But I will say AF, considering the bad start they got off to, held out pretty well. They managed to bait Secret into a couple of less than ideal engagements, but Secret was just so far ahead that there was just no risk to it.
Yep.
So I'm going to finally get a chance to reiterate this point for anybody who came into this game partway or is jumping around games. This entire success, honestly, Puppy is my MVP. His presence in the top lane being so successful, opening up so much space for early kills, made every single lane drop their way. There were no rotations helping Invoker mid. The Beastmaster was forced to completely abandon the bottom lane, which means that the Lifestealer got completely out of control as well. And it all comes down to the fact that they had to spend so much effort trying to keep Madara from drowning in the top lane under the pressure that Puppy was allowed or able to provide.
Gonna get the Roshan now. Wish I had would have done it earlier.
I know
get
you
it
are.
In between.
Hold on, let's see. I still have play with weak death, so.
I'm so wrong with everything.
You just you weren't secret centric enough.
Yeah,
it rhymes
probably.
Or it alliterates, so it must be right.
Even then, I don't think I would have picked the TZ for highest net worth or lowest.
No,
lowest deaths, or Puppy for lowest deaths either. Yeah,
highest net worth, but you know. It's Arteezy, so maybe we should have. Lifestealer is in there. The finger. That's a nice pick, and they're also going to get Eternal Envy.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, the game's not over, my friend. You write them off too soon. That's no buyback. They should be able to get a tier 1 tower on this as well. They might
cast
lose
curse.
Barracks because of it. Yeah,
it's actually planned.
Lose a range
to cast
barracks.
Curse. I want to pin them to win, so I'm cursing them. They glimpse back. They're going to work in favor of Venom. They can get Arteezy done. The Puppy's there with the zoning potential. He's still hanging around.
Oh, Pylai die in the back line, though. This is what I talked about. Madara just trying to blow him up and able to do so. We said it 20 minutes ago. I stand by it now. That's the way to win this game. Just make Pylai die your bitch.
Now, Teezy's still hanging around. He cannot actually do anything, though.
Yeah.
Not the glimpse back in the front lines.
Our Teezy may be a bit too deep now.
Madara's there. He does have the Silver Edge going. He's already starting to TP
Tornado?
Out now.
Tornado? Okay.
Not available.
Okay. Only two on Lex as well.
Yeah.
Thug is not high enough leveled. He's only level 16 on an Invoker at 30 minutes in the game.
With a Midas, too.
You gotta be keeping up. Yeah, with a Midas as well. Obviously, there's not a lot that he could do to get more experience, but it is painful when at this stage in the game you don't have that long-range Tornado, or at least medium-range Tornado interrupt, especially considering AF don't really have a lot in terms of interruption that can be on the front lines. Either way, that was a big series of kills. They pulled about 3,000 to 4,000 net worth into away from their own deficit on that.
Thousands, more than about 5k experience as well.
And hashtag Disruptor Midas coming out. I'm not sure when he bought that. I only just now noticed it.
Drop the Midas, okay. Are we ever Midas gaming? Is this where we're at right now? 22, okay, it's fine.
When
it's
you're
fine.
So far behind, I guess at a certain point it's just like, recovery Midas, whatever. Yeah. We're losing anyway. Like, it's not going to make us lose more at a certain point, right?
Yeah.
Disruptor could have gotten a Force Staff to help people get away from the Lifestealer and the Timbersaw, but whatever. This helps keep his levels up, which is really important because he's very rarely actually able to see the outside of his base. It's like watching the attack on Titan. Right, they're all caught in the walls permanently. And every time they go outside, some character dies, so.
Well, some more items come out. Arteezy with the Octarine Core now, going into transitioning to more of a standard build here. Lots of course, then the Lotus Opt this early, it's more situational, but this game definitely worked out so far.
Yeah, well, I mean, he got the Lotus Orb before anybody in his opponent's team had, like, any items, to be fair. So, when you have that much net worth, it almost doesn't even matter what you spend. Especially if you're a Timbersaw, who, once he has mana, once again, like the Elder Titan, almost all of his advantage just comes from his innate hero kit. It doesn't come from, like, the stuff that he can do with gold. Unlike the Lifestealer, right? Unlike most carries that use the gold to attack damage and stuff. Timbersaw doesn't rely on that effort.
Right. Still
has the Aegis, so this is also the reason why he was kind of a bit cavalier here earlier. Just trying to play a little bit of the Infinim, but he couldn't really get anything done. Was just sitting around hoping for maybe an opportunity to grab a kill with Infinim being close, too close to the crease or something. But yeah, didn't end up mattering all that much. He's still holding onto that for a little bit. Be reclaimed in 2 minutes or so.
Oh boy. This is. I mean, they don't need it though. You know, it's like an afterthought, the Aegis. So Arteezy is going to just dive in. He, like we said, has that Aegis. It will be reclaimed soon. So he'll be glimpsed all the way back.
How that dies to that.
Once
again. DKB popped. They want to turn this into something. Bulldog misses Crush though, but still delivers the Lifestealer. Dara, okay, gets his ultimate and the BKB just in time. Arteezy, no angle for this extra pure damage. Now Madara healing back up, looking for more targets. The stomp comes out of the back lines. Roar on the Bulba. That's gonna be the chosen hero. And Arteezy, his Dimmer Chain will be blocked. But Madara, everyone's dropped so low in the back line against Arteezy. Yeah, him and Envy, all they need to do is catch up. That's exactly what they're going to do. The stomp is stuck, no vision, so the Ghost Walk will protect him. Buybacks have to come out. That Finn is still desperately trying to hold on to the Rex, which is successful, mind you.
Yep.
They have used Salon.
Oh,
they
no.
need to find
more,
but Bulba just waiting for that moment here. Then dieback for Madara. Easily brought down with the counter initiation. The bait on onto Puppy. This might be it here. 1, 2, 3. No more buybacks available. Thug has to limp back to base.
That was a case where
Beastmaster
you gotta take
doesn't have the cooldowns. Yeah.
The very small victory that you got, that your opponents didn't take your barracks yet, and wait for a better pitch. Madara going in on that. I understand the motivation. He needs to get a kill in order to make back the money that he spent on the buyback, but the odds of actually getting a kill there and not dying are so small that is not even worth investing. You have to sit on your high ground. You have to sit with that advantage, or there's just no way for AF to win a fight, especially with fewer numbers.
That's 1-2, gonna
close.
Get the Mega Creeps if they want to. Arteezy just keeping them in the fountain if nothing else.
I will say this, right? Aof got off to a really bad start this game, and Secret had, in a rare case for them, they had a draft that didn't really greedily go into the late game transition. It went very, very well from the early game into the mid game. We can call it this action if you want, but Eternal Envy might go down.
That's still
maybe Puppy goes down.
TPing on the outside of the base, thanks to one of these still buildings still being alive. Kind of dodging Arteezy, who was kind of guarding the front of the fountain.
Yeah.
Let's get Puppy and Skylark.
But yeah.
I don't think anything matters at this point. It's only range extending between them and Mega Creeps, and that'll fall eventually.
So, you know, like Secret got off to a good start. They executed very well early. their laning decisions were just AF did not have a response to it, to be quite honest. Like, they didn't have a good response to do. But considering how far behind they fell, how fast they fell that far behind, and how few answers they innately have to Arteezy, were basically just the disruptor, they've done a really good job of being disciplined. Like, Madara is going out and finding Pilot Eye, which is, as I said earlier, really their only hope at getting back in the game. He has made a couple of mistakes, but his team overall has been holding out pretty well. Most teams would have fallen already by now, especially into Secret.
Oh yeah.
Having given up this much early game.
Last couple of pickups against them, 3k gold in total. According to the fight recap. Arteezy, 29 Bloodstone charges, as I said, only the range tracks, which will not regenerate anything. So Secret, if it comes down to it, Secret can just suicide on top of that, if they so choose. And for Arteezy, it's not even suicide. I mean, they did no damage to him earlier with just right clicks. They needed some sort of nukage, and they just don't have enough of that to chew through 3k health points.
Yeah, the idea that Ad Finem are going to actually hurt Secret if they dive under that rack is in and of itself extremely accurate. Arteezy getting caught by the whole team might die here, probably suicide. Yeah, there it is.
I spoke too soon, but hey.
I mean, he's out with all five with no allies, and he still got the suicide off, so.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say that you were that far off, to be honest, but yeah. Forcing Arteezy to suicide does mean that my prediction will be wrong. Oh, never mind, he's still low, as it's only his second death. Nailed it. Okay, there's a Bastion. That's actually a pretty big item pickup. Unfortunately, once again, another big problem that AF have is they have no wave clear whatsoever. So against two lanes of supers, how do they even get out of their base? The Bastion is not going to help with that, but they also need items in order to control their opponent's heroes that they're having trouble corralling in any significant way.
Yep. I just need like three or four different things to deal with what they're up against right now. And right now, the only reason that they're in is because Secret just started playing a little bit fast and loose, but did really kind of stop caring for a little bit now. But they had a little bit of fun. Not going back for the Throshan, they're securing this next fight back into serious mode, essentially, even smoking into the Throshan.
Not that they need it, but no reason to leave it there. We can be safe about it. Pylai Dai will have the cheese, the Aegis is there up on Bulba. And we're probably looking at the death throes of AF. But once again, you gotta give them credit, man. They are fighting it out very admirably, and they are making, for the most part, very strong tactical decisions. Not all, like, chasing off the high ground earlier was pretty bad.
Oh, just these backstabs once again. Skylark goes on the puppy. Nice force of power, so that'll look for Sunstrike. Four spells being thrown out here. Madara right in the middle of it, stacking up on this damage, but he cannot match Eternal Envy.
Yeah, there's the GG. It's just, you're too far behind if you're on AF. There's no... You could run this game for another 2 hours, and Secret could just, like, hang out and farm for 2 hours, and I'm not sure that AF would be able to come back even then.
I shall hide my shame on the incorrect predictions. You're absolutely right. At Venom, they're just fell behind so early. It was really no easy way for the